Now I'm going to use the same eyeshadow of MAC, which is this chocolatey brown, which is really nice. You guys, as Lisa said also, you guys can fill it also. You can use it on the eyelid also. You guys can even use it for contouring. It's really nice. So I'm going to use this brown color on
it's
her eyebrows.
It's actually the only color I have in my makeup pouch.
Yes, and guys, one more thing. She only introduced me to this MAC eyeshadows. Yes, that is also done by you. Because she uses the same color for the brows and eyes, Lisa
brows,
uses.
Brows, eyes, tip of the nose.
Yeah, tip of the nose, everywhere.
What shade is that?
It is a dark brown. I always go and get it. It's the...
It actually is a brow filler. It's a brow filler color.
It's...
Mocha-minded? Could that
Dance
be
in
it?
The dark. Sorry, dance in the dark. So I'm keeping it within her eyebrows. I'm not making it heavier or anything.
I think you should explain more about the eyebrows.
Yes. So when I was doing, when we were doing films together, we have realized the more, if you always want to look, get a softer look, we have realized that keep the eyebrows as soft as possible. If you guys are trying to make it really thick and strong, what happens is your face becomes harsh immediately. I know it's a trend right now to have really thick, nice eyebrows, really like defined eyebrows, but it really makes your face very, very harsh. And I've tried it with multiple actresses, with multiple camera people, and we always have realized when you keep the eyebrows as soft within the hairlines, it makes your face softer. So eyebrows are really, really important, and make sure that you guys don't use or make it too strong or too harsh, because that, and also I use sometimes brown, a highlighter kind of a cream on the eyebrows, but right now I'm not using because Lisa has blonde hair, but otherwise I use like a brown mascara to make the face more softer, because the darker the eyebrows goes, the stronger the face looks.
But even if you are doing a bushy, strong brow, there's yes. still a way to make it look like it's not pulling your eyes together, you know?
Yes. What you guys have to do is make sure that...
the thickest part.
Yeah, from the thickest part you start, because that's where you need the depth, and then blend with the rest of the color in the front and brush it out, and don't make it too clean. Like, take a brush and then clean it out and keep the natural eyebrows more bushy. Can you guys see it? Can you see? It's not really strong, and I just brushed it out. And I would say always keep your eyebrows like messy, because that looks really nicer. So we are done. And also another trick, you guys, if you guys have a really nice contouring powder also, you guys can use that for your eyebrows, which makes also face really soft. A really nice contouring powder also makes the face really soft. So can we have the straightening machine also? For Lisa, I don't really prefer to use lower mascara, guys, and we don't use it also because that makes Lisa's eyes look a little bit droopy. So, so for films, for a lot of actresses, I don't use lower mascara. Of course, in real life, it looks really nice, and if you guys are going on, but if you have really large almondy eyes, if you use mascara too much on the lower, have you noticed it? It droops your eyes a little bit. So for Lisa, I like to keep it a little bit simple and fresh.